So for the second half, or the workshop portion of today, I'm going to be going over how I made certain, I made some of the sounds in this film, and how you could do the same techniques to make soundtrack music.
好，就是这样，这就是这部电影，希望大家喜欢。那在今天活动第二部分呢，我将向大家介绍我是如何制作其中的这些配乐和音效的。So,
of course, many people, when they are making music for a film, will have access to many musicians, maybe an orchestra, and maybe a professional studio.
在很多人制作电影配乐的时候呢，也许他可以接触到一些好的音乐人呐，或者是好的录音室、好的交响乐团这样。
But when my friend asked me to do this, I obviously don't have an orchestra. I'm an okay musician, but not super talented.
那我朋友叫我做这部电影配乐的时候呢，我是没有这些酷炫的资源的。那我也就是一个很普通的音乐人而已。So
basically, to make similar instrumental sounds to what an orchestra or professional musicians would make, I use a process called sampling with Ableton Live, using their instrument sampler.
那为了达到像专业音乐人这样的能够做到很好效果的配乐的话，我基本上是用了 Ableton Live 里面 sampler 和 simpler 这两个功能。
So basically, to start, I'll just explain what sampling is. Usually, when people hear the word sampling, they think about maybe hip hop or house music taking a part of someone else's song and using it in their song.
那什么是采样呢？提到采样，大家可能会想到嘻哈音乐或者house音乐这样的集中制作方法，会用会把别人的音乐用到里面。
So just an example of that, there's this track here by Lou Reed.
Holly came from Miami, FLA. Hitchhiked her way across USA. Plucked her eyebrows on.
Okay, and this song was sampled in this hip hop song by a Tribe Called Quest. Okay, so you can see it's using a small piece of a song to make something new.
那关于什么是采样，给大家打个比方。那大家听到的第一首音乐的片段呢，是来自地下丝绒乐队Low Rate的一首歌曲。那这首歌曲呢，被一个hip hop的音乐人所采样。 他的做法就是把这个音乐里面的一小部分给截取下来，然后重新就是放在他自己的编曲里面去进行这个音乐制作。So
when you use a sample that you don't change very much, for example, in these two songs, sometimes people think of it as cheating or they don't maybe respect it as much. This is a constant debate. There's no real answer to it. It's more a matter of opinion.
那如果说你采样了一个部分，然后又没有把它给改变到太多的话，大家可能会认为你是在抄袭或者是作弊。这个想法呢，可能就是见仁见智的了。
But if you don't change the sample in any way, and the original artist finds you use their song without permission, you will have to pay them money, sometimes a lot.
那如果说你在没有得到本来的这个原创的音乐人的允许下面去采样他们的音乐片段，而这个事情很明显被他们发现了之后，你有可能会需要支付一大笔的版权费用。
But if you use some audio, someone else's music or any kind of recorded audio, and you pitch it up or you pitch it down, you can make this sample unrecognizable so that it sounds nothing like the original sound. And basically you can make something completely new with it.
那如果说你采样的这个音乐片段之后你对它的音高进行一些处理，或者是就把它弄得特别碎之类的，让它听起来不像原曲的话，就听起来像个完全全新的东西的话，可能会让你避免这样的问题，怎么说赔偿的问题。
So I'll give you an example of that. I don't know how many of you are music producers or what your musical background is, but this kind of technique can be used in any kind of digital audio software.
不知道在座的各位的音乐背景如何，是不是有音乐制作人在这里？不过无论如何，这个采样的手段都可以用在各种各样的音乐制作的场景中。
So, if I wanted to get a string sound, so string sounds are probably some of the most commonly used in movies, I would probably search for some kind of classical music to sample.
打个比方说，如果说我们想要用到弦乐的话，那弦乐是在电影当中可能最常出现的一种配器了。那我们可以去找到一些古典音乐的音源。
So I'm going to play a fairly famous classical music piece, called Adagio for Strings. Okay, so very beautiful.
现在给大家放的是一曲很有名的古典音乐的曲子，是不是很优美呢？
But you can also use this piece or something like it to create your own string sounds. So when you're looking for samples to play, I would suggest trying to find one long note. Okay, so one. Just one long note.
那我们可以在采样这个曲子的基础上面去，制作自己的配乐。那像我的方法是，我会先找到一个长的音符。
Okay, so I found that right at the beginning of this piece.
那我现在这首曲子的一开始这一段就找到了这样一个可以用的音符。
Okay, so one fairly long note. And what you want to do is on Ableton, you can go here to Instruments, find the sampler right here in this sample section. You can just drag or put your sample right here.
那你的做法可以是在这个 Live 的界面 Instrument 那一栏找到这个 Sampler 的插件，然后把你的这你切下来的这一个音符给拖进 Sampler 里面。Okay,
you can zoom in. You'll find the whole song here. If I just want to get rid of the rest of the song, I'll just hit crop sample here.
你是右键吗？Right click，right？就是你右击他刚刚演示那个地方，然后就选他那个是啥玩意儿来着？What you click? I didn't see it.
Sorry.
What did you click?
Crop sample.
Crop sample.
嗯，对，就选那个。
Okay,
so with Sampler, you can now play this song with MIDI. Okay, it can be a keyboard, or it can be a drum pad like this.
那你采样用这个 Sampler 采样好了之后呢，你就可以用你的 MIDI 控制器去控制它了，不管是作为一个鼓的 pad 还是作为乐器演奏的方式。
Okay, and if you don't have a keyboard, if you don't have a piano or a machine like this, you can just use your computer keyboard.
如果你没有 MIDI 键盘或者是 push 的话，你也可以用电脑的键盘来演奏它。
So if you play the middle C, this is the original sample, right? The same pitch as the first one.
如果你演奏中央C那个音的话，那现在听到的就是我们采样下来它本来的那个音符，音高是一样的。But
if you play higher or lower notes, the higher notes will pitch the sound up and make it play faster, whereas the lower notes will make it play slower. Sort of like if you play a vinyl record or a tape faster, the pitch will go up. If you play it down slow, or if you play it slower, the pitch will go down.
那如果你去演奏比中央C要高的音符的时候，它的音高会变高，但同样这个音符的演奏速，这个乐句的这个速度也会变快。 如果说你演奏比较低的音高的时候，它音高会变低，但是它的速度也会变慢。这个道理就跟你在黑胶或者是磁带上面快放和慢放的那个道理是一样的。So,
for example, I'll play higher, or You can see the sound right here. So you can see when I play it faster, it plays higher and faster.
那你可以看到，就是它这个数值那个绿色那个条那儿，就它会显示你就现在演奏这个音了。那大家可以听到，可以看到，就是说我如果说 把去弹奏比较高的那个音的时候，它的速度也就变快了。So
what you want to do to make it the sound not stop is loop it. So here you can see this loop plays the same sound in a loop. This one here plays it in a loop, but in reverse.
好，然后你看他刚刚点的那个三个小框框，然后第一个黄色那个小框框就是 one shot， 意思就是你就放一遍，但它会停，所以你让它不停的方法就是你点它那个第二个黄色，就点了会变黄的那个框框，它就是 loop 的话，就你采样的这一段它会一直不停的放，然后现在它鼠标上面放着的是 loop， 但是逆序的。
So when I like to loop it in reverse, I think you can get some interesting results that way.
我比较喜欢用这个 loop reverse 的功能，因为这样听着比较有意思。
Because when you play many different notes, the sample is playing at many different speeds, so it can give some interesting results that sound even a bit different than maybe an orchestra or a string.A group of string players would sound like.
那因为会有不同的速度产生在不同音高下，所以当他们被叠在一起的时候，也会有很有意思的现象，就像是一个交响弦乐团在演奏一样。
So, for example, I'll just give an example of many notes playing at the same time.
现在给大家演示的是同时在 MIDI 控制器上面 演奏不同音高的同时演奏不同音高的音符的效果。
If you want to make the sound shaped more to if you want to shape the sound more, you'll use the what's called the ADSR envelope. So you can see here attack.Decay, sustain, release.
如果说你想要更灵活地塑造这个声音的话，你也可以用到这个包络的功能，也就是我们说的 ADSR 去调整这个声音。
So if I want the sound to come more slowly, like a long, like a slow rise to the sound, you'll have a longer attack.So you can see right now I have 2 seconds. If I had it at 0 seconds, you turn it up to maybe, yeah, 2 or 3. And the sustain means as long as I hold this note, the sound will keep coming.It will keep looping.
那如果说你想要这样一个声音，它的音头比较弱，就慢慢起来的这种效果的话，你可以选择把 attack 调得长一些。那sustain 它的意思就是你在按住这个键的时候，它会持续的产生多久。
And the release just means how long the sound takes to disappear after you let go of the note.
Release 的意思就是在你停止按这个键之后，这个声音还会持续响多久。
So for example, if the release is very high, you can see here 7 seconds. Once I let go,It takes a longer time to disappear.
打个比方，那现在我们先把 release 的这个数值调得很高之后，那我放手不按这个键之后，大家可以听到 是这个声音还是持续响了挺长时间才停止的。
So basically you can shape your string sounds or your string samples to completely change the original sound and make your own melodies with this original one note sound.
那大家可以看到如果是这样的话大家虽然是采样的一个声音那我们也可以在这个基础上去很灵活的改变它的音高或者是旋律去做成你自己想要的效果。
Yeah, so you can have a lot of fun with this. Again, the main thing would be try to find a long one note piece of music. It can be from anywhere. But you can make it not recognizable by pitching it up and down and adjusting this envelope here.
那这个那这样这个我演示的做法总结下来就是说你现在可以先去找到一个长音就一个比较长的音符不管是从什么样的音源里得来的那你通过改变它的包络可以让它变得跟原曲完全不一样。
So Ableton also has a lot of recorded string sounds. So if you type in, for example, cello, see all results or orchestral strings. You can see some examples here. So I'll show you how you can make some different sounding string sounds that are also interesting.
那 Life 自己呢他也自带了很多的弦乐的音源像他演示的刚刚那些大提琴的声音那现在就来向大家演示一下怎么把它们变得不一样。
So here we can see a pluck sound. This was actually recorded by my friend on his cello, but Ableton has a similar sound.
那先给大家演示一个弹拨弦乐的一个声音。那他在电影里面用的采样的音源是他朋友录制的，不过 Ableton Live 里面也有类似的自带音源。
So here's the sample.Again, one long note. This one is from Ableton. But I'm going to show you this one here.
This is from your friend, right?
Yeah.
好，那现在放的那个第一个弹拨是他朋友弹，第二个是 Ableton 的音源。
So again, you take.The sound, you can also take it from your music library, your iTunes, and you drag and drop it into this part here of sampler.
那你现在可以把这个音源音轨怎么说呢 ？Audio 去把它给拖到这个 sampler 里面。
Okay, and again, you can pitch this sound up and down. So the original.
拖进来之后，你就可以改变它的音高了。
So this is the original.
刚演示这些都是从刚刚的那一个音符里面去通过 sampler 然后 用 MIDI 控制器去演奏，改变出它的音高弹奏出来的旋律。
So when you pitch it up quite a lot, it can sound like a completely different instrument, right? It sounds like a guzheng or something when it's this high. But actually, it's a cello, the original sound.
如果你把它的音高改变得高得太多的话，听起来就像变了一个乐器一样，像古筝或者是日本筝啥的，但其实它是大提琴的弹拨。
So this one I don't really want to loop because it's not a very long sound. So when you have sounds like this, often reverb can really make your sound a lot more cinematic.
那这一个采样的音源呢，我就不会用 loop 的功能去控制它了。像类似这样比较短促的声音，建议说可以用混响插件去让它听起来变得更电影化。
So to get the reverb, you just go here to Audio Effects, go down to Reverb, drag it over here.
要用混响的话，就在左边那个栏里面找到这个 Reverb 混响插件，把它给拖过来。
So basically with reverb, you're going to want to turn the dry wet means how much of it there is, and decay time means how long the sound echoes for.
在这里你可以混响里面主要可以调整它的 dry wet, 也就是干湿比，还有它的 decay time. Decay time 就指它的这个echo 这个回声会持续多长时间。
So I'll put the decay time kind of high, maybe 6 seconds, dry wet maybe 40%. But again, you can play around with this to make it sound how you want.
那我现在把这个 decay time 给拉大，把干湿比调整到40%。当然了，如果是你自己做的时候，你可以按照自己的喜好去调整。
So you can hear what this sounds like when it's pitched up and down. Especially when you pitch it down very low, it's good for kind of creepy sounds. Maybe you want to create some tension for like a horror movie or some kind of dark scene, maybe a more intense part of the film.
那现在大家听到效果就是加了这个混响之后的效果。那可以听到，如果你这个时候演奏非常低的音高的话，它听起来就会比较紧张一点，可能就很适合一些像恐怖电影啊，或者是比较紧张的情绪。
So yeah, this cello sound super low can sound quite nice in my opinion. And with the reverb, with the decay even higher.
我认为这样听起来就很好了，那我们现在再把 decay 调得大一点。
Okay, so again, that's just one. I just show you like two very small samples. So when you start to layer these things on top of each other, you can get some very detailed sound, soundscapes.
那现在向大家演示的是两个小小的采样技巧。那当大家自己做的时候呢，如果你把它们叠加起来，就会有细节很丰富的音乐出来了。
So obviously drums and kind of percussion sounds are very important for every music and also for film music.
那鼓的声音是对所有音乐包括电影配乐来说都是很重要的一个部分。
So, yeah, the same kind of idea to get some different sounds. You can take some drum hits. So here I have a xylophone hit. Oops.
同样的，我们可以在一些音源上进行加工。我现在这儿有一个木琴的声音。
Okay, so I take this sound. And you drag it to the sample part here. And you play the notes up and down. So one of the sounds I used in this film was a xylophone pitched really far down. So this is the original, or this is the original here. And when it's pitched very far down, again, there's some reverb on there, but you can get some dark textures from originally a very bright, high sound.
那同样的，咱们把这个 clip 给它拖到 sampler 里面去。那现在我们改变它的音高，就在这个迷笛上面去演奏比较低的音符，就可以听到，就整个音色的质感都被改变了。它从一个清脆可爱的声音变成了一个有点暗黑的声音。
Yeah, so adding reverb, maybe a bit of delay, also sounds always good, reverb and delay.
那我们给它加一点效果，像混响、延迟这样的。
Okay, another example is the singing bowl. I don't know if everyone knows what that is, but those bowls you can play, you kind of spin it around with a hammer thing.
这还有一个例子是那个钵的声音，钵就那个一个铜的碗，然后你用一个棍在它外面搅发搅发，它就会有嗯的声音的那个乐器。
So here's the sample here. So you take that, drag it into the sampler.
咱把它拖进 sampler 里。
Again, find the part that you like, loop it. I loop this one in reverse.
找把在里面去选取一段你觉得合适用的音频，然后这儿我选择了开启 loop 功 reverse 就逆向 loop 功能。
Again, you're going to want to adjust the envelope here. So maybe having a high attack, low, long release, and make sure the sustain is up here.
那这你还可以调整它的包络。这里我是把它的 attack, release 和 sustain 都调大了。
Okay, and you can see what you can get with this sample. I added some delay here. So yeah, it's obviously useful for other genres, right? It's very commonly used in ambient music and things like that.
那像这个声音呢，就是我采样之后进行处理，然后加了这个 delay， 也就是延迟效果的这个效果。那这样的声音呢，会在氛围音乐里面被用到很多。
This one is a looped kalimba sound. When you loop sounds that are more percussion, you can get some interesting reverse sounds.
下面这一个是卡林巴的声音，就如果你采样的声音它是更加打击乐的话，会怎么样 ？If it's more percussion, then what?
You can get just interesting reverse effects.
就那如果你再加这个 reverse 就逆向的这效果的话，会有非常有意思的效果。
So this is the looped.Kalimba sample.
This is a loop 下的卡林巴的采样。
Yeah, kind of interesting textures or strange rhythms. I used that in this movie for the scene where they were looking for Katya, the woman.
刚刚就是卡林巴，采样之后用了 reverse loop 逆向 loop 之后的效果，就听起来这个整个的质感就很有意思。
Okay, and for another one.Another, when you want to completely change the sound of something, you can create some really strange, kind of alien textures. You can use some of the echo effect as well on Ableton.
下面演示一些听起来比较怪怪的，像有外星人的感觉的一些效果。那这样的效果，你可以用到 Echo 插件。
So this, I like this one here, Ethereal Canyon. But I'll show you this sample here. Where is it? So it's a kind of a shaker instrument.
这是一个 shaker.是那个沙，我不知道这个中文要怎么叫，沙锤是不是
？Okay, so that's the original sound.
This is the original sound.
Then you put it in sampler, add some echo. This one is quite cool, Ethereal Canyon, but you can use any of them.
把这个 clip 拖进 sampler 里面，之后用上 echo 的效果。
And you can hear how you can really make some interesting textures with that.
你可以听到怎么样弄出很有意思的声音。
Again, this is looped in reverse.
同样，这个也是逆向 loop 的模式。
yeah, I think it's pretty cool to do this kind of thing.
对，这就是这些酷酷的声音。
And yeah, one more percussion one I'll show you, just is some more classic drums. I think this is some kind of Chinese drum, but I can't read what that says there, so.
还有一个想给大家演示的是另外一种鼓，它应该是某一种中国鼓。
But yeah, I just took this from a YouTube video, and yeah, downloaded it from the internet. You can hear the original sound here.
This music I was from YouTube 上面下载下来的。
But yeah, if you have any kind of drum sound, you can loop it or just have a one shot. And tune it up and down to get some interesting sounds. So, for example.
对，如果你有任何喜欢的鼓的声音，你可以把它采样下来，开启这个 loop 或者 one shot 模式。
Yeah, maybe you have some kind of battle scene or something you need to make sounds for.
这个听起来就好像是在某种决斗场景下面会听到的声音了。这个也是来自于他把这个一个音源拖进 sampler 里面，开启了 loop 模式的效果。
So yeah, ultimately, you.Hopefully you can understand the concept, which is basically to take any kind of sound, put it into a sampler, pitch it up and down, and you can maybe add some effects or change the envelope, and you can get some really interesting soundscapes. So this is probably my favorite way to design sounds.
希望大家可以理解这个概念了，那这个是我个人比较喜欢的一种做法。总的来说，就是你找到一个音源，把它拖进 sampler 里面，然后去调整它的，以不同的音高去演奏它，以及在后面加上一些效果，还有可以通过包络去给它塑形。包络也就是刚刚我们提到那个 ADSR。然后你之后就可以有一些很有意思的声音出现了。
And yeah, you can also record your own sounds. You don't have to use other people's sounds. For example, you can take something simple, like this is my friend pouring a bowl of rice into a bowl, and we can change that.
那你不仅可以是去采样别人的音乐，你也可以去采样自己录制的声音。这个声音也可以很简单，比如说这个声音是来自于我朋友把饭盛进锅里的声音嘛 ？Is that like put the rice in the pot?
In a bowl.、Yeah.
In a bowl, 就把饭盛进碗里的声音。
So you can hear the sound here.
是这样吗 ？Rice 是 cooked rice or uncooked?
Just uncooked rice. Yeah.
不好意思，是把米放进碗里，不是饭。
Okay, so taking this sound, again, same technique, put it in the sampler, add the loop, I like the reverse loop, change the envelope a bit, high attack, and add reverb.
那同样我们还是把它拖进 sampler 里面调整成逆向 loop 的模式再调节一下它的包络曲线之后再加一个混响插件
So yeah, you can hear what this sounds like. So using some filtering will also help here. Just using a low pass filter, which you can find in the filter section. Just change the frequency and resonance till you like what you hear.
如果说你调节它的 filter, 就滤波器的话，也可以有很好的效果。
Obviously, that doesn't sound like a bowl of rice, so you can see how you can manipulate sounds.
那很明显，现在它已经不再像米进到碗里的声音了。那你就可以用这些方法去控制、制作、捏制声音。
So yeah, that's I would say basically to conclude that obviously these techniques. Can't do everything, but I would say using them alongside traditional musicians, using them alongside synthesizers, vocalists, anything you want, it's not meant to discount the talent or necessity of instruments or musicians, but if you're looking to make some interesting sounds with not a lot of equipment, and maybe just Ableton Live, this would be my approach to doing that. So yeah, basically the idea is just to experiment, use whatever sounds you want, and just try to manipulate and mangle them as much as you can to get some unique things that we haven't heard before.
当然了，这个方法也不是万能的。它也不能够做到所有的你想达到声音效果。那我们学习这个方法呢，不是为了要贬低其他的音乐人或者能够真正演奏、制作音乐的那些方式。这种情况是在于，如果你没有很多的乐器在手边，而只想要用 Ableton Live 去制作音乐的时候。它会是一个很有效的方法。那这个方法它主要是在于一些实验的精神。你可以用这个方式去做出很多独特的音色出来。
Hi, Oliver. Thank you for the great seminar. And I have two questions. First is, I'm a bedroom producer myself, and I always find it hard to unify the different tracks, sometimes like if one of the sound is a little bit sharp or something. Mm. And I found it hard to unify the style of different tracks. So do you use same audio effects all the way, or you would like have some list of selection you have?
In terms of effects, I don't know, maybe you know this already, but I generally find that using like send effects can, like sending all of your instruments to these return tracks here can kind of make it all through the same place, so that can kind of put them together, maybe, and compressing them.
我是 Ableton Live 9的用户, 我的 Live 里面没有太多的这个音源, 尤其是当我想做一个我想要的那个音乐的时候, 我发现很难找到, 所以我会需要去网上下载, 但是我又发现在网上也很难找到, 所以你可以推荐一些就是你觉得有非常丰富音源的一些网站给我们吗?
Yeah, I mean, there is a website, I think, called freesound.org, which freesound.org, I believe, yeah. But yeah, I mean, I think the most important thing would just be to, I mean, I don't know how you listen to music. I don't know if you use like streaming or like QQ music or something like that. But for me, like the best resource is just like my iTunes, my music library. So whenever I find, like I have, you know, 20,000 songs in here, I can just take little parts of them and, yeah, switch them up enough to make an interesting sound. So like, for example, I don't know, if you're looking for like some strings, again, you could have some classical stuff. Maybe if you want some interesting sounding drums, you could find some interesting jazz. I would just say, yeah, just trying to listen to as much different music as you can, and trying to download it and plugging that, like Ableton Live 9 has sampler as well. So, you can just, yeah, use the same techniques that I was showing you. And, yeah, again, just, it can also be inspiring to listen to new music, searching for sounds like that way. You know, you can listen to some old, weird music, you know, from whatever time, and just use little parts of that. Yeah, that would be my tip.
All right, thanks.
How do you go about finding opportunities to work on film music like this? 想问怎么样找到这样在电影配乐的机会?
Yeah, I mean, this guy was my best friend for a long time. I wouldn't really say that I'm super well connected with the film community at all, but yeah, my friend just was, I was just really grateful for him to give me the opportunity to do it. I guess if I wanted to find more opportunity, I mean, he met a lot of people within the community while doing this film. And then of course, you know, that allows you to meet more and more people. But yeah, I guess the most important thing would probably be just meeting people at events like these, you know, this kind of going to places with like-minded people and talking to them and hopefully meeting someone who is doing some interesting project that you're working on. I mean, yeah, that's, I didn't go into it looking for this, but he just came to me because he was a good friend of mine. But yeah, definitely, I think for anything, the best thing to do is just networking with people who have similar interests to you and inspiring creative people.
Opul, do you have any other works, other material?
Recently, not so much. I mean, I'm sadly leaving China for the next in a couple weeks. So recently, I've just been trying to enjoy my last bit of time here. But yeah, I think I just released an EP on a label, which is more like dance music. So I'm trying to, I guess my next project would be trying to put something together for that. Also, shout out to Dabai and her boyfriend Justin, who I've been working on some stuff with as well, some kind of more ambient tape loop stuff, which has been quite fun. But yeah, nothing too serious. Just trying to make music until some magic happens, but don't have anything too big in the cards right now.
Of course, this is the humble answer. Opul has just dropped a sick EP that you can go check out. It's on Bandcamp. It's called Dadji. So that's quite a different style, of course, but if you guys are interested in Oliver and his music, you can go check out his latest EP. Absolutely fantastic, bangers. Very big thank you to Oliver for sharing his knowledge and his work today. And of course, thank you to Dabai for her wonderful translation.